this podcast, we'll provide an overview of the new features of EDIUS 9.10. New are export of H.265 via Intel QuickSync hardware encoder, XAVC proxy workflow, improvements of the media management software Mync, as well as further improvements in EDIUS. Let's get into the details of the new features. Export of H.265 via Intel QuickSync hardware encoder. H.265 is a new, more efficient codec. Compared to the widespread H.264 codec, it allows you to export smaller files with the same or even better quality. The color depth can not only be 8-bit, but also 10-bit. When exporting an HDR project, the created H.265 MP4 file includes the appropriate HDR flag. It is expected that H.265 will be in common use within the next few years. A lot of TV devices can already play H.265 files because they already have the appropriate decoders available. Since the complex H.265 encoding requires a lot of processing power, it is currently quite time-consuming. A solution for this issue is hardware encoders. The current Intel processors with an integrated GPU were extended with such an H.265 hardware encoder. EDIUS 9.10 is now able to communicate with these. Therefore, the requirements are processors from the 6th generation on, which have Intel QuickSync technology integrated. These are available since summer 2015. The 6th generation Skylake supports the H.265 export in 8-bit in the main profile. The 7th generation KB Lake and the 8th generation Coffee Lake additionally allow the H.265 export in 8-bit as well as 10-bit in the main profile. As the appropriate hardware encoders are only integrated in these processors, H.265 export is only possible with those specified. Without a hardware encoder, the H.265 export is currently not available. You can find a link to the compatible processors in the description. For updating your system, we currently recommend the i7-8700K processor with 6 cores and QuickSync support. This is also very suitable for working with 4K footage. XAVC proxy workflow. Most of the Sony XAVC, XAVC-S camcorders support additional proxy recording while recording. Earlier EDIUS versions were already able to import these proxy files. From version 9.10 on, EDIUS allows an extensive XAVC proxy workflow, which offers great advantages for TV stations as well as for individual users. The XAVC proxy files are located in the folder structure under Private, XD Root, Sub. They are available in the MP4 format with a resolution of 1280 by 720 or 640 by 360. Compared to the high resolution XAVC files in Full HD or 4K UHD, the proxies are relatively small. This, on one hand, allows the editing of 4K footage on simple laptops. On the other hand, the proxies can be transferred directly to the editing suite at the TV station from the camera, via FTP, or from the memory card via laptop. The editor can directly import the proxies, add them to the timeline, and cut it as he wishes. the files will be recognized correctly as Sony XAVC proxy files. This is shown by a symbol displayed to the top right of the thumbnail. When the high-resolution XAVC footage is finally available after a lengthy data transfer or via a memory card, the proxies can be replaced. For this, the XAVC footage is imported via the source browser. Go to XDCAM and open a new folder by right-clicking. Now, select the memory card or the directory where the private folder is located. Click on XD root. EDIUS now automatically recognizes the missing high-resolution footage. Agree that you want to replace the proxy files with the high-resolution clips. Then click OK in the following dialog window. As soon as EDIUS has the complete XAVC data available, EDIUS also automatically uses the proxy files. When switching to proxy mode via Menu, Mode, Proxy Mode, EDIUS no longer needs to generate proxy files as was required before. Improvements in the media management software Mync. You can now provide your footage with tags which can be set via shortcuts. This enables much faster tagging. To do so, go to Edit, Tagging, and set a tag. Now, select all of the clips that you want to provide with the previously chosen tag. By using the appropriate shortcut, you can add or remove tags. From now on, you can search your footage via tags. The new version supports working with subclips. To do so, select a clip in your storyboard. Set a new in and out point. Set the clip as subclip by right-clicking on the clip. If you have a long clip, you can easily create a shorter subclip this way. This also enables more accurate trimming. In order to divide your clip into fragments, duplicate the original clip and set the desired in and out points. Another new feature in Mync is the simultaneous preview of multiple still images. Select multiple still images. Right-click one of the images and choose Preview. The selected images will all be displayed simultaneously. This multiple still image preview option also simplifies the ratings process. Additionally, Mync can read and integrate more image file metadata. And snapshots which are generated in Mync from a video clip keep the original date taken from the source. Further EDIUS improvements. In EDIUS 9.10, certain issues have been fixed. For further information on these issues, please consult the README file. Another useful feature has also been added. When exporting and rendering selected clips, a progress bar is displayed on the EDIUS icon in the taskbar. Click here for the next podcast. To subscribe to our YouTube channel, click here. You can find more tips and tricks in our EDIUS podcast. Visit EDIUS.net for more information about EDIUS, plugins, tutorials, and the latest downloads.